Welcome to this tutorial on creating brochures using Microsoft Publisher 2013, created by the Instructional Media Center at the Mississippi State University Libraries. Publisher has many built-in templates that offer an easy way to create a brochure if you're new to the program. To create a brochure from a built-in template, choose File, then New, and select Brochure from the suggested searches. Browse and choose from the list of brochure templates available. Double-click the icon representing your choice of template, and your selection will open. The template will open with image and text placeholders that serve as a suggested layout. To replace images, click on the image placeholder, select Format under Picture Tools, and choose Change Picture. This will allow you to browse for a file on your computer, search office.com clipart, or perform a Bing image search. Here we will search the clip art for Classroom, select our image, and click Insert. This replaces the original image with our new image, and we can now click away to deselect those, select the original image, and press Delete. To adjust the cropping of an image, select Crop from the Picture Tools Format tab. This will allow you to reposition the image and adjust the crop using the black sizing handles. You can repeat these steps for the rest of the images. You can also use the arrange options to bring the images forward or backward. Text can be replaced by clicking in a text box, pressing Ctrl+A to select the text, and pressing Delete. New text can be typed in or copied and pasted from another source. To create a brochure from a blank document, choose File, then New, and select the blank 11 by 8.5 document. To create margins for a three-panel brochure, select the Page Design tab and click Margins. At the bottom of this window, select Custom Margins. Since most printers cannot print all the way to the edge of the paper, we recommend that your margins be set to 0.25 inches or greater at the left, right, top, and bottom. After those margins are set, click the Grid Guides tab. Increase the number of column guides to 3, and change the spacing to be double your margins. For quarter-inch margins, I will change the spacing between columns to be 1/2 inch. You can check the Add Center Guide between columns and rows to add an additional line which will indicate where the paper will be folded. Click OK. And now that the margins are set, I will draw rectangles to demonstrate how to lay out the first page of the brochure. To draw shapes in Publisher, go to the Insert tab, click Shapes, and select the shape you wish to draw. From the Drawing Tools Format tab, you can click the shape again to draw another. To label these panels, I will draw a text box and change my font. The far right panel will be the cover of the brochure. The far left panel will be the inside flap. And the middle panel will be the back of the brochure, sometimes called the mailer. To create the second page of our brochure, right-click Page 1 in the Pages panel and select Insert Duplicate Page. For the inside of the brochure, the panels are simply numbered from left to right. You can choose to leave your information in 3 columns or design across the folds, whichever you choose. Now that you have your brochure set up, you should be able to begin designing using text boxes, shapes, and the many other tools provided in Microsoft Publisher. If you have any questions or would like any additional help, please visit the library's website at library.msstate.edu. Thanks for watching.